Hello friends, we are back with the video series. This time we are targeting to complete all the GATE questions, targeting 2015, 14 and 13 as time permits, and also I have received many requests for solving many of the questions. So today's topic is based on digital logic, one of the important topic, that is counters and flip-flops. Okay, so hope you like all these videos, and in future you can just keep on requesting us. We'll try to provide as much videos as possible. So as we have seen in the previous slide, the question regarding gate on edge triggered flip-flops. So the given data is positive edge triggered D flip-flop, positive edge triggered JK flip-flop, Q output of D flip-flop. So let us draw the circuit. So the circuit would be So this is a D flip-flop, this is a JK flip-flop with the outputs Q and Q dash. Q output of D flip-flop connected to both J and K. So this output is connected to both J and K. Q output of JK flip-flop connected to input of D flip-flop. So this output is connected to input of D flip-flop. Now initial conditions are given. Initially output of D flip-flop is set to 1, that means initially this is 1 and output of JK flip-flop is clear. There is one more line, that there is a free synchronous clock. That means I may say that these two are working synchronously. Okay, so both will be triggered at the same time. To solve this, I generally prefer this format. That is the previous state, the flip-flop, so that is the D flip-flop, next state, so this is nothing but my QD, and this is QD, let's say dash, for the next state. Similarly, I will have previous state, that is Q for JK, this is my JK flip-flop. And as you can see, the input to JK is of Q. So that is QD and QD will be the input of JK, whereas input for D is Q of JK. I will get a next state over here. So that is Q of JK dash. Now you must be knowing the characteristic equation for D flip-flop. The characteristic is that whatever be the input, that is what we will get as output. Whereas in JK, it is when the inputs are same, it will toggle. When the inputs are 0, so it will toggle when? So if J equal to K equal to 1, it implies that there is a toggle. And if J equal to K equal to 0, means it is in a hold state. This already is the characteristic of JK, but is given as a part of your question, just to confuse you. Now, as we know, the initial state for Q, so that means this input is 1-1, as that is given over here, that input is 1-1, and this is given over here, so the input for D is 0. Whatever be the previous state, D flip-flop will do not consider this. So what we need to do, we need to just focus on this, because whatever the input of D is actually your output of that D flip-flop. So if this is 0, then this will be 0. Now what was the previous state of QJK? So previous state is given as 0. Okay, now if I am triggering, so now this two will be triggered at the same time. So first I am solving this at 0 input, I am getting 0, and for 1-1, now I am triggering this at 1-1, it will toggle. So previous input is 0, so next input will be, next output will be 1. Now this will be given as an input over here, so I will bring 1 over here. Similarly, the output of this is given as input, so I will get 0 0 over here, and this is the previous state. So previous state of JK flip-flop is 1 from there. Now again we will trigger it, so this 1 will generate 1 and this 0 will bring it in a hold state. Hold state means it will have the previous value. So I got 1 over 1. Again, this will given as an input to D flip-flop, this will be given as an input to JK flip-flop. Again applying the clock pulse, we will get for 1 as 1, this one is copied over here, for 1 I will get 0. Now this 0 is given as an input to D flip-flop, this one is given as input over here, this 0 is given to the previous state. Hope you are getting what the syntax we are having. The thing is, this is copied here, this values are copied to this two, and at the same time this is copied here. So now applying the clock pulse again, this 0 will generate 0. As it is 1, 1, it will toggle. So from 0 I will get 1. Again repeating following these arrows, I will see that this 1 will come over here as well as here, and this 0 will be given as an input over here. So this 1 will generate 1, and this 0, 0 will be in hold state. That's why this and this inputs are states are same. Going further, this will be 1. This will be 1 and this will be 1. So this 1 will generate 1 and this 1 will trigger it, toggle it to 0. So as you can see, the question is saying to identify the bit sequence starting from considering the initial state. So what was the initial state? 0. And after that, what are the sequence we are getting? 1 1 0 1 1 0. So finally I can say the sequence which I am getting is 0 1 1 0 1 1. And 1 1, or let's say we are including 0 and so on. So as per the option, it is option A. Hope you understand this. It is very simple. Whenever such flip-flops are given, you just need to consider what the flip-flops are given. You need to know the characteristic equation, you need to know the excitation table. Okay, based on this, the things are very easy. Draw it, meet the previous state, next state, previous state, next state. If you know that previous state is independent, then just ignore it, as I have ignored in D flip-flop, but I have not ignored in JK flip-flop, because this will help me. Even if you masterize this, then you can ignore certain columns from here. Definitely, it depends on how much good you are at this, but if you are a beginner, then definitely you need to know all these columns. Okay, hope you like this and do subscribe. Thank you.